I said our responsibility to reach people. I didn't say my responsibility, because this is, we're the church, amen? The church is more than one person. And so when I read this, I thought about Peter in this passage of Scripture, and I began to think about churches and the reasons why I think a lot of churches have stalled, and the reason why a lot of Christians, I think, are not happy, and they've lost their joy, and even Christian homes. I was thinking about this the other day, and listen, I've talked to more people in the last month, more married couples in the last month than I've talked to in a long time, Christian people whose homes are struggling, and I believe with all my heart it's because there's a lot of dirty Christians today.
Amen.
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 And I want to say real quick that this is not what I wanted to preach today, by the way.
Right.
You know, I wanted to preach on the cross. I've got my sermon already in there, but the Lord wouldn't let me. And so one thing I do want to do, I want to do what God tells me to do. Amen.
Amen.
And I don't want to slight him, because this is not my church. It's his. And so I want you to listen to the message this morning, and because I really believe that you're going to hear a lot better sermons than this one. And that probably won't be preached by me. You're going to hear a lot of sermons that are better than this. But there, I believe, are very few truths more important in your Christian life than the one that's mentioned in this passage of Scripture. So I want you to listen real close, and I want you to pay attention to what the Holy Spirit of God may be talking to us about today, because I do not believe that there's another passage in the Bible that explores our need for cleansing any better than this passage of Scripture that we've just read. And so I want to show you kind of what's happening here in this passage. We're in the habit, or if we were in the habit of walking around on dirty roads and dusty roads. Now, well, I did that as a kid. When I came to Carrollton, I didn't realize. I thought when I went down the first alley that me and my wife went down in Carrollton, Texas, I thought we were on another street. You know why? Because the alleys where I grew up, they're not paved. They've got ruts in them. Amen. I mean, I didn't know what it was like to have an alley that was paved. But listen, but back where I came from, they were dusty roads and dusty alleys. And if we were in the habit of walking on these dusty roads wearing open-toed sandals, we'd better understand what's going on here as a custom in the Lord's day. You know, when a guest showed up at a person's house in the Lord's day, the host would have his servant wash the guest's feet. Now, the guests, they may have bathed, they may be clean, they may have on the best cologne, they may have put on their, nice Armani suit and all these kinds of things, but when he got where he was going, his feet was going to be dirty. Why? Because they wore sandals and they walked around in dusty, dirty places, and they sweat, and I began to think of how disgusting this job might have been for somebody to wash these guys' feet. Now, first, listen, I think God has a sense of humor. And the reason I say that, God has made some beautiful people, amen? But he put ugly feet on them. Amen? I'm telling you, listen, I don't go around looking at people's. I look at folks' shoes, but I don't look at their feet, amen?
Right.
Because I'm telling you, there's some folks that got some pretty funky feet. Amen. Y'all say amen. And the last thing I want to do is let somebody get all sweaty and are their feet wet. Listen, my kids, when they came in outside dirty, they were dirty sometimes. I can remember Mallory. We would tell her to come. She was our tomboy. She loved to play in the dirt. And I'm telling you, she'd come in, look like she'd been in the hog water. Amen. And we would tell her, hey, it's time to come in the house. Sherry and I was talking about this just yesterday. And we'd say, come in, you got to take a bath. And she'd say, her words were, I barely got to play, you know. And she'd been out there all day. And she was dirty. And I'm telling you, but the last thing I want to do is wash somebody's dirty, nasty feet.
Right.
Amen.
Right, right.
Well, here we're seeing this very thing happen. One day, Jesus and his disciples, they began to gather in the upper room, and we had an opportunity to go there one time, and it's what they showed us was similar to perhaps the one where the Lord and his men met, and they came to this upper room, and they began to gather around one by one, and And but when they got there, there was no servant there to meet them and wash their feet. So they sat down, and they were probably thinking, somebody's going to volunteer and do this lowly task of washing feet. But watch, nobody did that. Nobody volunteered. And when I thought of that, I thought there's a lot of lowly tasks in churches today.
Right, right.
Amen.
Right.
And I think we get like the disciples did that day. We're all waiting for somebody else to come and volunteer to do those lowly tasks.
Right. Amen. Right.
And so, but nobody did that day. The disciples, I can see them there. They're all reclining. By the way, they would recline like this. They would sit, put their elbows on the table, and their feet would be out behind them. And so whoever would come by would wash their feet. Well, nobody did that. Until after supper, you read here, the Bible says that the Lord Jesus, he got up and he took a towel and he girded himself. He took a basin of water and he started going from one disciple to another, washing their feet. But when you read this verse of Scripture, if you look in verse 6, it says, "Then cometh he to Simon Peter."
Right.
Listen, my first thought was that means that he had already washed some of them's feet.
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen?
Right.
Because it says, "Then he cometh."
Mm-hmm.
That let me know that that when he got to Simon Peter, that Peter is the one that spoke up. And one of the things I thought was, well, you know, I don't understand Peter's personality. He's always saying things. Amen?
Right, right.
But why is it that Peter was the only one that we read that spoke up and said something to the Lord about him washing his feet?
Yeah.
But he did. And when he came to Peter, Peter said, "Jesus, I'll never allow you to wash my feet."
Right.
I mean, Peter, think about it. He was embarrassed. Servants wash the feet of kings. Kings do not wash the feet of servants. And yet they knew that he was the King of Kings. They
right.
knew that he was God's Son in the flesh. And yet he washed their feet. And so Peter says, "Listen, I'm not going to allow you to do that." He's embarrassed. But Jesus told Peter, he said, "Peter, if I don't wash your feet," then he said, "you have no part with me."
Right.
So
right.
Peter said these words. He said, "Well, then if that's the case, give me a bath." Listen, that's why the song Brother Shelton just sang. He said, "All of me, Lord." Right. Not just my feet, but all of me. Mm-hmm. And so Jesus has to explain some things to him. And Jesus said, "Peter, you don't need a bath. You've already bathed. You just need your feet cleansed." Now, this lesson that the Lord is teaching, I think it's a very profound lesson, but it's also very simple. And the first thing that it teaches us is who needs to be cleansed. Listen, now watch this. So I'm asking, who needs to be cleansed? The answer to that is all of us.
Mm-hmm.
Every
Amen.
One of us need cleansing.
Yeah.
Listen, the Lord knelt at the feet of every disciple in that room because every disciple had walked on a dusty, dirty road to get to that meeting place. And folks, and every Christian today in this building needs cleansing. Not saving, cleansing.
Amen.
Listen, but cleansing from time to time, we all need cleansing. You say, "Well, why?" Well, because we all walk in a dirty world. And as we do, the dust of sin collects on us. And all God's people can say,
Amen.
Amen. Listen, we all get dirty with sin. Sin gets on us by way of the television. It gets on us by way of the radio, the internet, ungodly workers. I mean, even other Christians sometimes who are out of the will of God. So let me ask you, can you remember the last time you knelt at the altar and dealt with sin in your life? This is why, because we all need to be cleansed. Washing Amen. And cleansing are very misunderstood today. Jesus approached Peter to wash his feet. And that is to wash, to clean the dirt and the pollution from the lowliest part of his being, his feet. And we all need today regular cleansing. And the fact that some haven't received it explains why sometimes Christians' attitudes and spirits get so rank.
Mm. Right.
You know, some people's feet sometimes, I mean, kids play outside barefoot. We used to do it all the time. I don't know how we survived, growing up. We drink out of a water hose.
Right.
Hey, man, we play outside barefooted.
Right.
My brother ate June bugs. I mean, we did all kinds of nasty stuff, amen. And yet here we are. But we got dirty. And it's the same way with you and I as Christians today. And if we don't get cleaned up every once in a while, listen, our spirits become terrible.
Amen. Amen.
I think it explains oftentimes why prayers go unanswered. I think it explains why many Christians today have the loss of joy. Listen, have you ever been so hot and dirty that you couldn't wait till you got home, got in the shower? Listen, I'm telling you, when I was working out in the oil field, we didn't take a shower, but we couldn't wear our work clothes in the pickup going home. We had to go down in the doghouse, and we had to, where we had our trapping clothes, and we might wash our hands off, and we might wash, you know, our faces, but we would change back into our traveling clothes, get in the car, the truck, and we would drive a couple hours back home. And then when we got home, there was a lot of times when I was living at home, my mother said, listen, you go in the garage. You take all them. I said, well, these are my traveling clothes. She said, well, Dick, you still stink. You go in there and get you a shower. Well, back then, I would, I was okay. I had clean clothes on. I figured that did the job. Amen. Well, listen, it didn't do the job. You know what? I worked all day. Well, listen, when I think of that, I also think about coming to church on Sunday. Oftentimes, we put on good, nice, clean clothes. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all stay with me.
Yeah.
But we put clean clothes over spiritually unclean bodies.
Right.
Amen. And so when we come to church, there still is a need of cleansing today. We all need cleansing.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something, the way the dirty Christian feels spiritually, that we get dirty in the world. When we get to church, we ought to be in the mindset of, man, I can't wait till the invitation starts so I can go get cleaned up. I am dirty. I need to get clean.
Yes.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Listen, we all need cleansing. You say, well, how do we get it? Well, the best verse to use, I think, in answer to that question is one that I quote all the time. It's 1 John chapter 1.
Verse Amen. 9. That's it.
It says, if we confess our sin,
yes,
then he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sin.
Yes. Cleanse.
Cleanse us from what? All unrighteousness.
All unrighteousness.
But I'm afraid that a lot of us don't go far enough with this matter of confessing. Now watch, we tell the Lord, yeah, Lord, I did wrong. And that's as far as we go. Are y'all still here?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all are awful quiet. Listen, we go and we tell the Lord, yeah, Lord, I did wrong. Forgive me. Wait a minute, that's not far enough. That word confess there in 1 John 1:9, it means to agree together. For you to be cleansed, you have to agree together with God about your sin. Oh, the preacher, wait a minute, what do you mean that I have to agree with God about my sin? Well, for one thing, you have to agree with God that the wrong you did was sin. Watch, as long as a Christian tries to maintain his innocence, think about it. When he goes, when he has done wrong, or else he puts the blame on somebody else, listen, then you will not receive cleansing. If I say, oh, Lord, I messed up, but if Brother Shelton hadn't have done what he did, then I wouldn't have done that.
Right.
If so-and-so hadn't made me do that, then I would not have been there. If so-and-so hadn't have done, and then, Lord, you just know, you know me. God, no, wait a minute, you're not going to have any cleansing. Y'all still with me? Say amen.
Amen.
Listen, we can't do that. We must agree with God that what we did was sin. And as long as we do not, though, listen, we'll not ever receive cleansing. And I'm afraid today that what we've done is we've made up our own list. We've made up our own list of what's right and what's wrong. And we want to go by our own revised rules.
Amen.
Y'all still with me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid that on our list of revised rules that we want to, go by, listen, it don't match up with God's list.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is God's list right here. Mm-hmm. And yet we make up our own and they don't go by. Listen, be careful. Listen, the Christian that does that, I'm afraid that their list of sins usually contain, big sins, big name sins.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, Lord, I'm, and what comes to my mind right now is the Pharisee and the publican. You remember the publican, they came together and the Pharisee, you know, God, I'm glad I'm not like that guy. You know, I'm glad that, man, I don't do what he did. I give alms and I fast twice in a week. And
right.
Man,
right.
I go to church every Sunday morning. And Lord, I try to do my best. I'm good to my neighbor and blah, blah, this. And man, I'm sure glad I'm not like him.
Yes.
Well, listen, that's the wrong thing. We have tried to measure up to that wrong person. We need to measure up today to the Word of God. Not
right.
to him or me,
right.
but to God's Word today. And if we don't measure up to this book, this is the list of sin. If we don't agree with God what's in here, listen, then we're in trouble. Mm-hmm. We've got to agree with God that we ought to quit sinning.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. I mean, just stop.
Mm-hmm.
You know, watch this. To confess your wrongdoing, watch, while intending on not to stop, or sometimes we say, Lord, I've done this and this and this, and God help me, and Lord, I need help with this, and then we get up and we go right back and start over, all over again. Listen, there's no cleansing in that whatsoever.
Yeah.
We've got to come to the place where we agree with God that was sin, and that I am not, with your help, going to do that ever again. You say, well, what if we do? Well, as long as you're trying not to, listen, and you're giving it your very best, and you're praying and ask God to help you, listen, then there's forgiveness of that. But a willful sin that we continue to do it over and over and over, never one time thinking it will ever stop, the Bible says there remaineth no more sacrifice for that sin. There's never a cleansing. Listen, we must agree with God that it's sin. But watch, we need to also agree with God that all sin can be washed away. Listen, it's sad to see a Christian who thinks that he or she has lost God's favor and they can't get back. You know, that's sad.
Yeah.
I've talked to people, and they have said, well, preacher, you don't know where I've been. You don't know what I've done. And listen, 1 John 1:9 is still in here.
That's right.
And
hey,
there's
good.
No list of expectations. It just makes a simple statement of fact.
Mm-hmm.
And that statement of fact is, if we confess
yes.
our sin,
yes.
that's
amen.
What it says.
That's right.
Say amen.
Amen.
If we confess our sin,
that's right.
If we agree with God and say,
yes.
God, listen, what I did, that is wrong, and I agree with you, it's wrong, and I pray and ask you to forgive me and give me the strength not to ever do it again,
right.
and I walk in the power of the Spirit of God. God, please
right.
help me. Listen, then God says he is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all our sin. Amen.
Yes.
Listen, nobody is so far gone that they can't get back to God and get cleaned up.
Yeah.
Listen, we've got to come to him for cleansing, though. And I'm fearful today that a lot of Christians are trying to worship, and they're in churches today, and they've got their own list and their own standards. But folk, God help us. I was talking to someone just the other day about something in our life, and I say, listen, if it's wrong in your life, then you can't expect to tell somebody else not to do it.
Yes,
if you're,
right.
If it's wrong in your life, then you can't have a relationship with anybody. Listen, your relationship with God has to be right first, and then it'll get right with everything else.
Yes,
listen,
yes,
God
yes.
expects me and you first and foremost to be clean, and all God did
yes.
say it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's
you
good.
You say, well, what's the purpose of cleansing? Well,
yeah.
Look what the Lord told Peter in verse 8. The reason, he says, if you don't wash, if you're not cleansed, then Jesus said you have no part with me.
Yes, yes, yes.
Listen, our fellowship with Jesus depends on whether we're clean or not.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever tried to spend leisure time with somebody that you're having a serious disagreement with?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it is really uncomfortable. Amen?
Amen.
Not too long ago, I met with someone who invited me out to lunch, and you know, they had come to visit the church, and they had some questions about the church, and not too long after we sat down, the first thing they started in was, you know, talking about the church where they were going, and they were saying, oh man, I'm telling you what, our preacher, he's against this, and he's against this, and he uses the King James Bible only, and he's against this, and he's against that, and they said, man, and he is just a legalistic kind of guy, and he said, so we're looking for another church. What do you think about all this stuff?
Oh wow! Oh wow!
Put you in there.
Well. You know, from that point forward, let me just say that we had trouble enjoying one another's company. And the reason being is because a lot of the things he was for, Scripture's against.
Uh-huh. Right.
I'm not going to compromise those things. And I think that's what's wrong with a lot of Christians today. Because we've made our own list and because we're not clean, that your fellowship with God has been broken.
Mm.
You know, I mean, think about it. Y'all just stay with me. I think we got to get back to the part where church is important to us.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got to get back to the part where church is a priority in our life. And when I say church, I'm talking about worship.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was glad when they said unto me, "Let us go up into the house of the Lord."
Yes.
Listen, are you glad? I'm really glad when it's time to come to church.
Yes.
I mean, Sunday, now stay with me. Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night. I had some people not too long ago tell me, saying, "Man, I'll tell you what, preacher, we're just going to." It's been a couple of years. They said, "Preacher, I'm telling you, we just can't come anymore because you expect us to be at the church every time the doors are open." Not me, God.
Right.
I said that. I didn't say that. You don't shoot the messenger.
Right.
Amen.
Listen, we ought to want to come to God's house. It ought to be a priority in our lives, and nothing should get in the way of that.
Yes.
But we started playing around with that a little bit. We got lackadaisical about our church attendance. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
We can't do that.
Amen.
Because if God's going to bless us as a church, and we've got to be serious about church and about people.
Amen.
Listen, we can't play.
Amen.
If this is a serious business, people's souls are being weighed in the balance today.
Yes.
We can't let have Aunt Susie get in our way of worshiping God when it's time to worship God.
Amen.
Listen, when it's time to be here, we ought to be here, period.
Yes. That's what the Bible says.
Forsake ye not.
Right.
You still love me, Abraham.
Amen.
Listen, that's what God said.
Amen.
We've got lackadaisical about, you know, we've done real good about the physical things and aspects of the church, and man, I'm thankful for that. But we've got to get serious about the spiritual stuff. Y'all say it? Go ahead, say it.
Amen.
I'll tell you now, Brother Shelton, he's my accountability partner. And he sent me a text not the other day, and the Lord, he don't know it, I hadn't told him, but the Lord really get me about it. Something that he said he's not doing. And I thought, man, and the Lord's been, he's tapping me on the shoulder and telling me about this, and you know what? I'm really kind of miffed at him. Amen. But you know what I'm doing? I'm shooting a messenger. God just reminded me something that he put in here.
Amen.
And so, man, me and the Lord, guess what I did? I agreed with God.
Amen.
Amen. And I said, okay, Lord, you got my attention. And again, he's ignorant about the whole thing. He doesn't have a clue what's going on. But the Lord, he's using him. And you know what? It's not him. But it's God through him. That's why you have accountability partners. Y'all, if you don't have one, you ought to get one. A spiritual accountability partner. Somebody that can help you. Somebody that can, just encourage you. Not only encourage, but challenge you. But, you know, we talk about reading God's Word every day. Listen, we talk and he'll send me something. You know, read this and this. And I'll send stuff about I read. And I've been still, but every once in a while, there's something that I don't do. And it's easy not to do if you're not careful. But listen, the devil knows where your weaknesses are. I heard someone pray this morning about and said, God, you know my weakness. And I'm telling you, the devil will exploit that weakness every single time.
Yes, yes.
But we've got to get back to the list that God's made for us. And the purpose of that cleansing today is that we have a right relationship with Him. And when we come to get cleaned up, we know that we get our joy back. But most importantly, we know that if we're clean, that we have part with the Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Because if we're not clean, you can't fellowship with God.
Amen.
And I think that's what's wrong with a lot of Christians today, that their fellowship is broken. You know, we look for all kinds of reasons to be, you know, to be out, and when we ought to look for reasons to be in. And if we're not clean, watch, the Lord says you have no part with me. Listen, when you have the dirt of sin on you, any truly spiritual activity will turn you off. Think about that. You're not involved in the spiritual things of the church because you need cleaning. And the devil knows that. When I was thinking about this morning and I sat down, I was sitting here and I was just began to think and pray in my thoughts for just a minute. I thought, you know, the devil, I've had my sermon out on my desk. And the old devil, he knows what I'm going to preach.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, and he wants to do everything that he can to keep you from being clean.
Mm-hmm.
He wants you to put it off. He don't want you to be involved in the spiritual things. But we got to be careful. Titus 3, verses 3 and 5, this is what it says. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving divers lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful, hating one another. But after that, the kindness and love of God, our Savior, toward man appeared. Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy He saved us. Watch, by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost of God. You know, sometimes, like Peter, Peter didn't get it. But after the Lord started to talk to him, he understood what Jesus was telling him. And Peter understood the importance of being clean. And there's no such thing, think about it, there's no such thing as holding back a part of your body or a part of your behavior for self to do as you please. There's no such thing as a partial cleansing. Brother Shelton sang a song this morning, and the title of it is All of Me. All of Me. You know, sometimes we want to come to the Lord and say, Lord, just wash my feet. Or just wash my hands. But sometimes our thoughts need to be cleansed. Sometimes our actions need to be cleansed. Sometimes there's a cleansing going on that we need that we want to just say, no, Lord, that's okay, you know. But God wants us to be clean everywhere. And it starts in the heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I thought about the Lord when, as he's on the way to the cross, by the way. And those men are sitting around. And I thought, you know, with Jesus going through, those guys didn't realize, I don't think, the pain and the anguish that he was going on in his thoughts. And yet he still stopped and took time to wash their feet.
Wow.
You know how unselfish that is.
Mm-hmm.
For the Lord Jesus, you know, to do that for us. But he did.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, to live clean, we got to be clean. To be clean, we have to come to Christ regularly, confessing our sin. And the reason is, we live in a dirty world, and we get dirty, so we need to be clean. So let me ask you, when's the last time you got clean? When's the last time you had a good washing? I'm talking about spiritually. When's the last time you came to the altar and said, Lord, not just my feet, but all of me. Listen, Peter got it after that, and you and I need to do the same thing this morning. Listen. Clean Christians. Clean Christians are fruit-bearing Christians.
Amen.
And I think today, you and I today, we really ought to think about where we are with our relationship with God and ask ourselves, am I clean? In the sight of God this morning, am I clean? Father, we thank you again for loving us. Oh, what a neat picture you gave before. I can't believe, Lord, that you stopped and took a towel. Nobody else would do it, but Lord, you did.